Hello again, and welcome back to the card mat. A bit like deja vu this for me. Tis. I done a review on this deck, and before I uploaded it onto YouTube, I deleted it for some reason. I don't know why. I had no idea. Honestly, no idea. I went to get it to upload it, and it wasn't there. Yeah, so... Unfortunately, it's been opened and been examined previously. So, I'll do the best I can with it. Got a very nice design on the front. I'm not telling you what they're called yet. All nicely embossed, all golden green embossed. With a nice border going around it. I hope you can see all the little bumpy bits on the middle as well. The pattern all embossed on it. Around three sides, you've got a gold band around three sides, which adds to the effect that it actually looks like a book. But if you look at that side, it looks like the spine. You know, one of them classic books. Like over here, it'd be like a Reader's Digest. Yeah, we all know what the Reader's Digest books look like. But it looks like a book, if you see what I mean, doesn't it? It certainly does. Down here, it's all nicely embossed in the gold, all nicely embossed. It says, the collected works of psychological illusionist London's Derren Brown and Theory 11 of New York, purveyor of unrivaled playing cards. Yeah, and that's what the deck's called. Playing Cards by Derren Brown, courtesy of Derren Brown. So as I say, it just looks like a book. There's your cover page, there's the book. Unfortunately, it doesn't open up that way. No. Very nice little seal on it as well. Opened by Royal Decree. Illusionist. First edition playing cards, incomparable quality, it says on the seal. Seal's already broken, as I say. The inside of the box is nice as well. All of the box on the inside is all like that, all the way down, as you can see, all the way down to the bottom. Even on the back and the front sides, which you can't get in this light. But very nice design on it. Very nice indeed. Very nice case for the cards. The cards have got a green back to them. Green on white. Yeah, it would have been nice if they would have had the gold, but they've decided not to go with that, apparently. Yeah. Very, very nice. And the cards are all mixed up, apart from these ones. There's your ad card. Very nice ad card, looks like a billboard. Playing cards, courtesy of Derren Brown, the psychological illusionist from London town, published by Theory 11. Very nice. You'd also get two jokers, as you might expect, in a packet. Two identical jokers. Now you can either say it's a devil angel or an angel devil. The good and the bad. Yeah. Both identical. Ideal for a lot of tricks, having identical jokers. And this is ideal for a lot of tricks. It's a double backer. Yeah, I'm not just turning it part way and then turning it back again. No, I'm not doing that. It is actually a double back card, which is always useful to get in a packet of cards. Let's just tilt this down a bit just so you can see a little bit more. You've not seen none of that. Yeah. The only downside to this packet is two identical jokers. Very nice, but you might have thought that one of them would have had a little reveal on it somewhere. If it has, I cannot see it, and I did have a good look at these on the first view when I gave them. Same with the backs of the cards. I thought it might have been a very nice little marking system. Darren Brown, you know Darren Brown. Yeah, it would have been ideal. Would have made the deck more special. It would have been some kind, unless I'm totally blind and just cannot see it, but I cannot see no kind of a marking system on the cards. Which, I'd say, would have been nice. The pips are pretty nice. A bit of an unusual club. It's not as fat as you'd expect it, and joined up as much. Nice heart. If you look at the bottom, if you look on the club at the sides of the stalk, it's like a little round ball on the end of it. It's not going to a point, it's like a little round ball. And that continues through it. On the heart, on the point of the heart, it's not to a point. There's like a little blob, shall we say. You've seen a spade, you've seen a heart, you've seen a spade. Here's a diamond. You see on all four of the points on the diamond, it's just like a little added blob to it. They've just gone over the lines with the pen, as they were calling it in. What else do you need to see? A spade. Here we go, here's a spade. The top point on the spade, it's not a point, it's more of a bobble. Yeah. But the pips are genuinely 3 sevens and a six. Standard. The picture cards. Nice little orangey tan. Yeah. Look a bit like David Dickinson. Yeah. A lot of you might know who he is. He's an antique dealer over here. He's always on the telly a lot. Cheap as chips. Yeah. And he's always got an orange complexion because he's always gone overboard with his self-tan. Yeah, we all know who David Dickinson is. Some picture cards. But as I say, pretty standard. Pretty standard style, shall we say. They're not exactly the same. And again, you might have thought you might have done something with the faces. Although, they don't look any... Yeah, they could look similar, I suppose. But they've all got the same moustache. Yeah, Jack of Spades. The Aces. I mean, look at that. I'll show you that one first off. The Ace of Clubs. Now, you might have thought straight away, as soon as you've seen all of that, that could have been the Ace of Spades. But no, that's just the Ace of Clubs. The Aces are fantastic. The Ace of Clubs. Ace of Hearts. Very intricate, nicely designed. Not very often you see things like that. The Ace of Diamonds. It's always good to have, it's great to have a very special Ace of Spades. But to have the other aces nice and elaborate as well is very nice. Talking of the Ace of Spades, look at that. Looks like an infinity mirror. If you look at it closely, you've got a hand holding the card. And on the card in the middle, it's the Ace of Spades. So there's a hand holding the card, which is the Ace of Spades. And in the middle of that, there's a hand holding the card. Yeah. And if your eyesight's really good, you'll see it going right the way back. Till you go blind. Yeah. Theory 11 presents the Ace of Spades official playing cards, courtesy of Darren Brown. I didn't just make that up, it says that going around the card, believe it or not. King of Clubs. There's one more King I want to show you. I won't show you none of the results. Can you see something strange? I said there's no reveals. Can you see something strange about that King of Hearts? No. Well, to me, it looks like he's got two left hands. Yeah. I know it's supposed to be that hand with that hand. But the way it's done, it looks like he's got two left hands. Doesn't it? Two left hands. Or, as I say, that hand with the sword is supposed to pair up with that hand going down. But it doesn't look like that. It looks like he's got his hand held up and then another one going up with the sword through his head. So that does look a little bit strange. You might have put a bit more thought into the way they designed that one. Bit of a talking point, actually. King of Diamonds, yeah. And we'll get to my little lady, shall we? I'll show you my little lady and I'll get off and shut up. My little lady, looking as lovely as ever, the Queen of Spades. Yeah, what a dishy card. Yeah, very nice. So there we go. Playing Cards by Darren Brown. They are very nice. They are very nice. They do handle well. Look at that. Very nice spread. I still can't pick them up. Very nice spread. They furrow beautifully. No effort at all. He says, not being able to do one. They furrow in lovely. They dribble. Well, every card dribbles. Every packet dribbles, I suppose, but listen. Very, very nice. Very, very nice. As I said, the only downside is you'd expect from Darren Brown some kind of a reveal, some kind of a marking system. I say, unless I am missing it, but I don't think I am, because I've got very, very sore eyes staring at the cards trying to spot them. And I can't. That's a club. That is a club. Yeah, but does that look the same as that one? Yeah, it does. And that's a spade. Yeah, that was just a good guess saying that one was a club. Oh, and on the... I didn't tell you. You hear that? You can play music on the side of the box. That little border, because it's supposed to look like a book, it's got little lines going through it. You know, like the edges of the pages, as you can hear. And it is, that's embossed up as well, you can feel it. It's looks lovely. A great deck, as I say. I'd give these 9.25. The only downside is you would expect from a name like Darren Brown some kind of trickery involved with the packet, and not just a double backer, because that's pretty standard in most decks nowadays. They cost me £10.50. That's 10 English pounds and 50 English pence, which I'd say was a good deal. Honestly, I'd say it was a good deal for this packet. I do look forward to using this, and I hope you look forward to seeing me use it. Anyway, I'm going to shut up now and get off and finish the rest of my drink. I hope you've enjoyed that. I hope I do not delete this one. If I do, you won't get to see it. And I'll see you again soon.